century. The Black Death is a bubonic plague, the most serious epidemic whole of human history. On the time of the 14th century, a population of Europe reached 90 million. This is the 100 million, and population of Europe on the 2nd century, approximately, we estimate to 50 million. On the time after the collapse of Roman Empire to the 6th century, decreased around 20 million. To the 10th century, it's a recovery on the Middle Ages, High Middle Ages, reached again a 50 million. This is the trajectory of European population. And finally, to the 14th century, reached 90 million. And this situation are overpopulation. Carrying capacity of contemporary Europe, it's approached the ceiling of carrying capacity. Moreover, started a climate deterioration. This is the first century of Late Ice Age. Late Ice Age was the coldest period whole of human history. 10,000 years long history. This is the deepest. For example, in London, on the ice cover of Thames and ice cover of Seine, in the case of Paris, organized a winter fair, because a Seine in Paris and Thames in London frozen over. This is the Late Ice Age period. 14th century was the first century of Late Ice Age. Overpopulation, underfeeding. Two types of underfeeding existed. In the last week I spoke about, but I would like to speak about the problem of the crisis of 14th century in Uni. Therefore, underfeeding, a quantitative underfeeding, not enough calorie, and a qualitative underfeeding, not enough fine element of the feeding, for example, vitamin, nutrition, and trace element, and so on and so. And agrarian crisis launched in the second century of 14th, second decade of the 14th century, which described in the chronicles as green harvest. Why? Because not enough long the vegetation period for ripe a whole of cereals, wheat and dry and barley. Therefore, had to harvest on green the seeds of cereals. Okay, basically this is the same as I throw over there on the table. This is the trajectory of population change. Obviously, you can see, you can realize how lost for 7 years one third of European population in consequence of Black Death and the subsistence crisis. The background of the crisis are climate changes, and changes the carrying capacity of European agriculture. Medieval warm period, which was the background of Viking discoveries in the North Atlantic Ocean and the North Atlantic region, it's closed and started the Little Ice Age. The name of Little Ice Age, it's named after increase and the growth of glacier. You know, a glacier, this is the frozen river in the mountain area. It's flow very slowly, only 10 or 20 meters per week, very, very slowly, but it's flexible. But the flexibility is like ice. And the size of the glacier increased on that period for a lot of 100 meters. Why so important the glaciers? Because in the transhumance animal husbandry, you know which is the transhumance? Transhumance, no? It's a transhumance animal husbandry. This is the system of animal husbandry in Alps, in the Alpine region. During the winter time, the cattle, based this kind of animal husbandry to the cattle, it's living on the winter time on the valley. Generally on stain in building. But when on the springtime, open vegetation walking up on the slope, up to the mountain area. And very important, drinking of animal. Why? Because one cattle able to drink 50 liters only once water. In the high mountain area, very rare the endless watering and endless drinking place. And a melted water of glaciers, important place of mountain area of transhumance cattle wandering. Not by chance, on the end of glacier, construct some building for animals and for shepherds. And when change the position of glacier, destroy the shepherd hut, for example, the temporary stable of animals. Therefore, the contemporaries wrote down the information how changed the position of the glacier. Good. For example, we can realize the snow of glacier in the Alpine region, alleged glacier, how changed. Why so interesting? Because if we are looking a cold period, we are able to realize after this diagram, it's not mean change the temperature. No, change, there is a anomalies, positive and negative anomalies, but warmer period and colder period, differences between cold and warm period change the average and change the scale of animals. If we are looking at the recent global warming, recently there is a trend of changing, but even in global warming may happen and might happen a cold period, because in the climate change we can describe with anomalies, not only with averages. Good, turn back. It's not interesting. Look at the next slide. The next slide interesting for us because our event of subsistence crisis of 14th century try to describe not in the modern time, in the modern demography or history or geography, but even the contemporaries. Quite a famous early scholar, Thomas Robert Malthus. He was an Anglican priest, in England, of course, and he tried to understand in his age, at the turn of 18th and 19th century, which is the reason of the subsistence crisis. And he described one of the most important conflict in the historical demography. If we are looking at the population and capacity of agrarian production, time by time opened a wide a season. Why? Look at, for example, a traditional family. A husband and his wife. Which is the productivity of the traditional family? The key factor of traditional family's productivity, the fertility period of women. The classical fertility period of women start in 40 and close around 40 years. Every second year, possible one birth. Therefore, the productivity of traditional women may calculate around 12 births. 12 births. But very high the infantile mortality. Very high. For one adult, necessary 2 births. Each second birth closed with death of child after the 10th anniversary. Therefore, there is a chance for maximal fertility to survive a sixth child. And look at the couple, look at the small family. One family able to try, even in the traditional traditional society, but the Armenian capacity able only a growth 10%, much smaller. Therefore, time by time, according to Thomas Robert Pattus, open the season of fertility and agrarian productivity. Therefore, a brace, a demographic brace, closed the season. And according to Thomas Robert Malthus, in the 14th century happened a classical Malthusian crisis, overpopulation, and an epidemic closed the season. But the situation not so easy, not so easy. Look at other description of the crisis. Other description of the crisis, the first Malthusian model. It's a resource problem. Time by time, open the season, overpopulate the local population, and the brace, epidemics, famine, and war closed. But not so easy. Look at one other approach. Balance between population and the structure of land ownership. In contemporary Europe, existed two kinds, two types of inheritance system. A primogenitor, it's a first son inheritance system. Every estate received the first son. Yeah, but in the last week I spoke about, but I would like to describe whole of the process of 14th century crisis. Okay, primogenitor. A primogenitor produce useless, unnecessary person. It's some very interesting social form of overpopulation. On the early high Middle Ages, an unnecessary person, for example, in the nobility, moved to the Holy Land. It's a crusade. A crusade exported an unnecessary person from Europe. Not by chance, in the 13th century, closed the crusade. The last Christian fort conquered by Muslim troops. Okay, look at the third description of the crisis. Complex, no, turn back. Balance between primogeniture, only one. Look at the second one. The second one, a parallel inheritance system. What mean the parallel inheritance system? Each son and daughter receive the same proportion. But the problem with the parallel inheritance system, that after some generation, so small estate receive the offspring, that according to economic logic, it's a dwarf estate. It's not efficient. It's inefficient, small and tiny unit of estate, not able for rational production. Okay, look at the last one, complex relation between population and agrarian production and the market. First, before the railway network, no efficient communication system in the continental world, not only Europe, everywhere on the world. No efficient, not by chance, a traditional time, a great cities located on the seaside, lakeside, and the riverside. Like, for example, Paris on the riverside of Seine, like, for example, Amsterdam on the seaside of Northern Sea, and Stockholm, the capital of Sweden, on the lakeside of Mälaren. Why? Because bulky products able, quite cheaply, bulky products able to transport only seaborne or waterborne trade, no any other. Not by chance, when appear a railway network, a continental cities increase the size. Why? Because the railway network function like a river and decrease the expense of the trade. First. Second, no information about the market. It's possible, for example, in Amsterdam, it's very high the price of the cattle. But in Hungary, which traditional animal husbandry area, no information about the high price of cattle. Therefore, nobody wants to go to the direction of Amsterdam. No information. Not by chance, the first journal, the first newspaper which published in Europe, economic newspaper, economic newspaper with the prices, with economic information about the trade and so on and so on. Okay. Basic problem of pre-industrial economy are physical obstacle. A lot of physical, no bridges, for example, no bridges on the rivers, but the borderline existed not around the country, inside of the country, among and between estate and the estate of the noble. Transaction cost is very high. Why? Because the inner borderline necessary to pay a fee. Local quality, yes, correct. Okay, good. Political fragmentation, a lot of small units. This is the age of feudal anarchy. A feudal anarchy. This is the fight among a lot of feudal lords. Therefore, one merchant would like to travel one place to other, it's very dangerous because no generally accepted legal system. No. Moreover, nobody able to forecast the political and military situation in other places of the Europe. Coordination failure and a very general upheaval and warfare, this is the feudal important peculiarity of the feudal anarchy. Look at the Black Death. Look at the Black Death. If you are looking at the Black Death, some contemporary picture about the Black Death and the map of proliferation of the Black Death, but turn back to the basic elementary information. In on the verge, there are two areas, East Africa and outskirts of Himalaya, where a plague, which is the bacterial infection. A plague is a epidemic, not epidemic, it's a, how the name is a local infection. Why important the local infection? Because in this area, living, not in the historical past, but even recently, living rodents, a small mammals like that, which carries a bacteria without symptom. Carries the bacteria, but without real epidemic, real sickness, real infection. Like a container, like an animal container. In general, normal situation, it's not dangerous for the world. But the triggering, you know which is the trigger. Trigger, this is the necessary to push in the shotgun and firearms, everything. And triggering effect means a small operation, only pushing the triggering effect, but launch the chain of interaction. We are not able to stop. Okay, a triggering effect in the epidemics and the pandemics are drought, a dry period. Why? Because this is a natural disaster. On the dry period, on the period of drought, every part of the biosphere destroyed. Vegetation, flora and fauna, prey animals and predators. But when stop and close a drought period, launch and start a recovery. But recovery capacity of prey animals like rodents, much higher, much higher. For one rodents, for production of offspring, necessary only 3 weeks. 3 weeks, it's very short. And predators, a lot of moth. Therefore, rodents, a container of the bacteria, overpopulated and flowing out from the original homeland and met with gray rat. Gray rat. Recently, in the global rat population, a gray rat, it's a very small part, very small part. But historically, it was the best friend of human, lived together with the human settlements. And very interesting, in the literature, For example, I don't know in the Asian literature, but in the European literature, the gray rat is a quite typical actor. And very interesting, did you read Harry Potter, G.K. Rowling? You remember how the name is Wormtail? Wormtail. It's a rat of Ron Weasley. Ron Weasley, a friend, the closest friend of Harry Potter. And animal of him, it's a gray rat. It's a Peter Pettigrew. Peter, you know the story? No? Harry Potter? Okay, Peter Pettigrew able to transform a rat. But this is not only simple, it's a gray rat. It's a special. But why is it so interesting? Because Rowling, who read our English literature, this is a reference to the early modern English literature. Because the most important actor of the early modern English literature, the gray rat. Okay, but it's a literature context. But turn back to the story. A starting point, it's a rodent who are able to read and carry a bacteria in the outskirts of Himalaya, Central Asia, and East Africa. Drought, infected animal, it's left the homeland. Mad with gray rat, infect a gray rat, and the living place of gray rat and the humans overlapping. Therefore, a gray rat only a bearer of infection, but the vector of infection a flea. A flea. Somebody personally met with the flea? Flea? No? It's, you know the flea. It's jump on the butt. No, nobody. Yeah, you have. I am very glad because I live together. Recently, it's too, but during my childhood, I slept together with my cat. And my cat at least 10 or 20 fleas had. And there is special skills flea hunting, you know. You are able to kill the flea? Because it's a special kill. The first operation, have to concentrate the moving of flea. The next one, it's push down and take picking the flea and turn to the nail and kill. It's very special skill because my friend came from urban area, not able to kill because it's a special practice. Friend of my mother was so sensible the skin that she was able to kill a flea during she's sleeping. Yeah, it was unbelievable. And for example, she slept and somehow in alpha phase realized moving a flea some part of she's body and picked and killed on the end of the closing part of the bed, and when woke up, counted how many fleas killed during the night. Okay, but it's a special story. Turn back. The real size of flea, not the same. It's a microscopic photograph. It's a very small animal, very small animal. But very important, there are a lot of different subspecies of flea. A pig, a cattle, a horse, a dog, a cat, a human. Why? Because the nature of skin is skin basically different. Because a human skin, generally, it's naked. But the surface of skin of cat, it's a very, very hairy. Therefore, different. And a normal situation, a fleas are very loyal. But the infection situation, it's not normal. Some picture about consequence of plague infection. Therefore, name Black Death, because the peripheral blood circulation it's frozen down, and the peripheral blood circulation, a finger and the toe, it's became time by time, it's a darker. Okay, look at the interaction. The first step of interaction, free drinks red blood that carries the bacteria. The second step, bacteria multiply in flex gut inside of free, and the gut clogged with bacteria. Therefore, a free drink the blood, but never arrive to the stomach. Therefore, it became a crazy and jump and jump and jump and jump and bite everybody. And from the mouth of free, it flow back to the microblood circulation. This is the mechanism of infection. It's a vector, really. A free is a vector, a proliferator of infection. And free bite human, red gargitates the blood, and human finally infected. Okay, generally the great infection proliferate on the world via great trading routes. On the Middle Ages existed two great trading routes on the contemporary world. The first one, the blue one, the Great Silk Road, and the red one, sorry, and the blue one, the Great Spice Road. Of course, not only spice, not only silk distributed in the Great Silk and the Great Spice Road, but the most valuable, the highest values products was one a silk and the second a spice. For example, pepper's value was the same with the gold value. 1 kilogram pepper was 1 kilogram gold, and the value of silk was similar. And a bubonic infection came from Central Asia, outskirts of Himalaya Mountain, arrived to Europe via a Black Sea and the Mediterranean basin. We know the place when the first European infected. It happened in the Crimean Peninsula. Probably you know the history of Crimea. Somebody visited the Crimean Peninsula? Nobody. Very interesting place, because when I was a student in the 80s, in the 20th century, the Brotherhood in Hungary was much stronger via Soviet Union, and I'm part of geography. And we visited in Odessa, in the northern port of Black Sea, and very interesting. If you have a chance, I suggest you visiting in Odessa. Unbelievable, unbelievable city. For example, on the harbor cover with Vesuv stone, Vesuv the volcano in Italy. Why? Because in the 19th century, a lot of cereals, a lot of wheat exported from Ukraine to Italy. And backward, no any products. Therefore, one Russian, it's very interesting Russian mentalities, it's invented, it's possible, much easier walking on the street in Odessa, covering with Vesuv stones. And brought back a huge quantity of Vesuv stones. Therefore, in Odessa, bourgeoisie walked in the port, walked in the Vesuv. Vesuv is a quite high part of the culture of Roman Empire. Okay, I turn back to the story. Crimean Peninsula, it's overlapping a lot of different culture. For example, in the antiquity, Crimean Peninsula was a part of Greek world, a lot of Greek colony founded in Crimean Peninsula. It's named Theodosia. This Theodosia, it's a Greek name. In the Middle Ages, a Genoese trader, it's reconstructed Theodosia and named to Kaffa, and recently named Theodosia. It's possible you name, this is the Russian name, Theodosia, one of the military bases of the Russian army recently. Okay, I turn back to the story. It's a fortified Genoese city, trading city. And I remember 1346 took under siege one Mongolian army. But wasn't able to conquer the city. Therefore, applied an early version of biological weapon. The soldier who died in play tumbled in, thrown in with catapults to the city and infected the population of city. Not by chance, a Genoese trader with his commercial vessel brought to Europe. And Europe, on that time, overpopulated and underfeeded. In the traditional time, the most important condition of survival, a good condition of immunity, a good feeding. But majority of Europe overpopulated and underfed. Not by chance, very quickly proliferated infection. And for 7 years, one-third of European population disappeared. And very strange disaster was, because not only the underclass, not only the poor people died, but the feudal lords too. Why? Because it's a quite new bacteria and no natural immunity. Therefore, not only the underclass, but everybody might die. Okay, which was the reaction of contemporaries? The general reaction, scapegoating. You know the mechanism, a social mechanism of scapegoating? Somebody know? No. Scapegoating. A scapegoating, it's described in the folklore of Near East. Look at the classical scapegoating. There is a village, a small village, and an employee of local community is going to each family and recon the scene. For example, smuggling, lying, it's a sins, this crime, and select a black buck. You know, black buck. It's a goat, you know. Select and organize a local fest, everybody drinking, and on the end of public fest, the local officer read the sin of community in front of the goat. Black buck. And the end of reading of the scene of local community, drive the black buck to the desert and left alone. This is the public ceremony of cleaning of community. A cleaning of community, scapegoating. And the buck on the desert will die. And each year repeat the public cleaning of community under the sea. Like, for example, in the Roman Catholic Church, there is it's a part of the praying. You can tell, you know this custom, which is the term for that. It's speaking the sin to the priest of Roman Catholic Church. And there is a law, there is a possibility for the Roman Catholic Church for annulation, for canceling of sin. But this is a public ceremony. It's a scapegoating. Okay, but the scapegoating function not only with animals, but with humans. And divine, we are not responsible for the punishment of the gun, but may select one community, generally minorities, for scapegoat. For example, aliens. Not from the universe, aliens from the neighborhood. For example, Jews. It's a quite typical scapegoats of European history. Or Muslims. Because in the boundary of the Mediterranean Sea, on the on the coastal area of Mediterranean Sea, quite large massive communities lived even in the Middle Ages. And Armenians, because it's other Christian community. And which is the simple solution? Killing the scapegoats. Killing. It's quite harsh solution. And the next one are women as scapegoats. In Middle Ages, quite rare the witch hunting, except the disaster of the Black Death. Why? Because on the time of Middle Ages, turned very special direction in the Roman Catholic Church. Generally accepted, it's quite unique in the Christian community, as celibacy. You know which is the celibacy? Celibacy is prohibited for the priest a marriage or any connection with women. It's a little sin if somebody break a celibacy. But if somebody once declare that I broke the celibacy, live together and spend together with one night with women, it's possible annulate one only, one possibility, one bonus of the life. But for the women, no other option, because a women device of devil. And which is the normal solution with the device of devil? Necessary to kill, the best solution, it's a burn, the device of the devil. Therefore, in consequence of the crisis, as scapegoat, it's started a witch hunting. And the firm group of scapegoats are flagellant. You listen about the flagellant? And this is the large, quite a large community named a flagellant brotherhood. A flagellant brotherhood is a large community, more than 1 million members had in the frame of flagellant community, and the conclusion of that, we are responsible. Therefore, we have to punish ourselves, walk on the street and beat themselves. And sing, for example, a different ecclesiastical song. Beat, beat. And very interesting, a flagellant hated a contemporary lord. Why? Because a flagellant agreed, we are on the days of last judgment. It's end of the world. And on the time of last judgment, not necessary pay in the taxes. And the feudal society lived that everybody paid the taxes. Therefore, the contemporary armies, it slaughtered the flagellant community. Why? Because it's tried to avoid that everybody didn't pay in the taxes. Okay, how try to save the community themselves? The first form of the defense, a quarantine. A quarantine, it's a Venetian, it's a dialect, Italian dialect used in Venice. Venetian dialect, quarantino, it means 40 days. A 40 days. A 40 days mean that somebody arrived from infected area close to some building, some camp, some district of the city for 40 days. If no any symptom infection, might continue the travel. But if appear the symptoms, generally die inside of the quarantine. And not by chance, recently we are looking the COVID-19s using the same technology like in the Middle Ages, a quarantine. The next one, extenuation of disease bacteria. How functions the extenuation, a weakening of disease bacteria? Look at two actors of infection, a man or woman and the bacteria. Which is the most successful bacteria? Because in the bacteria, look at the side of bacteria. In the side of bacteria possible, a strong, a middle strong and a weak. Which is the most successful bacteria? Obviously, the weakest bacteria, the most successful bacteria. Why? Because the strong bacteria kill very quickly the human. Therefore, no chance for proliferation. Therefore, generation by generation, the base of bacteria became weaker and weaker and weaker. Why? Because the weak bacteria, the most successful bacteria, able without early death proliferate the infection. Look at the other side, human. Some part of human, even in the Middle Ages, had some natural immunity. I don't know why. Natural immunity had. Therefore, if somebody had a natural immunity, able to survive infection. And able, generation by generation, increase the rate of natural immunity. And very interesting, if we are looking in the historical process, generation by generation, decrease the efficiency of bacteria and increase the immunity of human. Increase, decrease, increase, decrease. And there is a climax point in the middle of 18th century without any curing, any medical curing, disappear, a plague. Whole of Europe disappear. And recently the plague infection exists. For example, in the area of Mediterranean Sea, India, some local infection, but never became a global problem, a plague. Okay, this is the extermination of disease bacteria. And finally, a self-regulating family system. A self-regulating family system means a local community try to avoid an overpopulation. You remember the story? A husband and wife. Fertility years started around 40. You know, for example, a play, a Shakespeare play, Romeo and Juliet. Juliet was 40 years. And her mother told me, why you would like to wait? You are even 40 years old. You have to be a mother in your age. Okay. Start 40 years and close around, it's a statistical simplification, around 40 years. Therefore, there is a chance for 12 offspring, half of for high infantile mortality, it's a die, and only 6 there is a chance for living until adult age. And on this time, the strongest legal system, a customary law. Never described, but everybody knows. It's a customary law. And the customary law try to manipulate institution of marriage for decrease the chance of overpopulation. Which is the most efficient? Okay. Witch hunting, though? Long term, okay. Self-regulating some family system, a little bit more detailed description of that. Describe first a French historical geographer, Lyon. Okay, documentary sources, natal, marital, and mortal parish register. Fertility period of women start 14 and close 40 years. High infant mortality rate, and the most important device of manipulation of offspring, of birth, it's a first women's first marriage, age of women first marriage. Why? Why first? Why first? Because on the okay, my guess, in the traditional time, how long the term of marriage? How many years living together? 30? 40. 30? Other offer?
50?
50? The last one? 7!
7!
7! 7! Because very high the chance for death. Not only, for example, you know the Hieronymo Bosch. It's a very famous, German painter. Hieronymus Bosch. He painted a lot of map about the death. And in the Middle Ages, the death, not only the problem of old people, not only the problem of old people, it's a problem of every generation. The young and the Middle Ages and the old one too. And very important, that very easy to die. For example, military campaign, for example, epidemics, for example, problem with birth. Therefore, a majority of marriage closing with death of husband or wife. Therefore, a normal structure of traditional time and remarriage. A lot of times, remarriage, remarried. Recently, how long a marriage? 7 years. I don't know why, but recently, not for the death of man or husband or wife, close the term of the marriage, but divorce. But very interesting, in the traditional time, not necessary the institution of the divorce. Why? Because time by time, husband or wife die and open the way for remarriage. But it's very interesting, 7 years, this is the license of marriage. Okay, but turn back to the story. Age of women's first marriage. Contemporary society prohibited very harshly birth out of marriage. Therefore, the rate of birth out of marriage changed from 1 to 2 persons. It's very moderate. Therefore, a marriage was the institution of birth. No out. It's a quite a close society and very heavily controlled the life of each other. And therefore, in crisis period, a local society aroused the age of first marriage and decreased the term of fertility. Look at, for example, England. History of England, a Tudor, you know, there is, for example, a television series of BBC, a Tudors. This is the age of Henry IV and Elizabeth the First. This is the 16th century. In this period, the deepest crisis, one of the deepest crises, whole of the English history. And the age of first marriage of English women on the Tudor age, 40 years. 40 years. Why? Because the country was a deep crisis. For birth left only 10 years. During 10 years, there is a chance for 4 born birth, 2 die, left 2. Therefore, the society only reconstruct themselves. Therefore, the late marriage, no modern invention. It's happened even the traditional time for demographic manipulation. Okay. Good. And somehow necessary to solve the problem in state level. And modernizing of the government and the state try to destroy the market monopoly, the coordination failure, and political jurisdiction. Turn two direction, a European political evolution, a centralization, for example, absolute state and later a national state, like. For example, England follow France and Russia in eastern part of Europe, centralization. Other direction, a feudal institution, for example, Poland and the Napo, but both Poland and the Napo disappear as a state. For example, Poland divided by Habsburg Empire, Prussian Empire, Prussian state, and Russia. Therefore, this is the feudal direction, parcelization, and the second one, this is the main, the highway of European evolution, a centralization. A centralization and increase the power of government. Okay, it's not interesting. Very interesting, crisis of Black Death opened a way, opened the gates for adaptation and new plans, and new plans. It's possible, in the last week I told you a story that a traditional peasant society is very conservative, very conservative. I remember my father ate until his death the meals which socialized during the childhood. No new one, no new one. We visited, for example, marriage fest to Budapest and serve modernized meals, modernized plates, and my father closed whole of the dinner without any tasting of the meals. Why? Because he was a very conservative. I remember during my childhood arrived a Bulgarian gardener to my village. And in eastern part of Europe, a Bulgarians, it's a quite good, only the best gardeners all of the region. Therefore, the Bulgarians, it's a synonym of gardeners. And arrive a Bulgarian gardeners and try to proliferate vegetables. But the peasant rejected, because we ate sausages with sausages. It's no compromise. And I remember that one day my father worked on the estate of Bulgarian gardeners and as prison received some vegetables. Arrive at home, it's not happened in the Middle Ages, it's happened in the 70s, in the 20th century, and this don't know vegetables my father took down on the table, viewed. It's by surprising, it's edible, not edible. My mother told to his friends, picking information of cooking and so. It was eggplants, you know, which is the eggplants. It's recently quite a general, but in the conservative villages culture, if possible, rejected any invention. But the disaster and the famine and the starvation opened the way toward a new plants. And invented on the times rice, spinach, sugarcane, artichoke, and the eggplants in central and western part of Europe. Therefore, European agriculture is somehow decentralized with the new plants. Okay, it's not interesting. Changed a little bit the structure, urban structure of contemporary Europe. And look at my final conclusion. If we are looking at the final conclusion of the 14th century crisis, we can use a summary of Stefan Robert Epstein. He is professor of London School of Economics. And he summarized his conclusion, the next one. The late medieval crisis is the best understood as an exogenous demographic shock, which triggered a process of institutional creative destruction. You know the term of creative destruction? No? It's very important. Because it's introduced an Austrian economist. His name is Josef Schumpeter. Josef Schumpeter. Josef Schumpeter. He described the modern European society, history of modern European society and the development of modern institution with the term of creative destruction. Why? Because in Europe a lot of revolution happened since the French Revolution. the French Revolution and the Bolshevik Revolution and the Chinese Revolution, a lot of revolution, local revolution, revolution in Cuba, and why happened a revolution? This was the key question. And according to Joseph Schumpeter, a creative destruction and creative destruction of civil war and revolution somehow destroy. Look at, for example, a Bolshevik revolution. A lot of million people died. In Ukraine, at least Ukraine, 3 million. 3 million in the Great Hunger. But destruction may happen because necessary opened the way for innovation. Very high the price of introduction of innovation, but the traditional Russian government and political system wasn't able to solve the problem. Therefore, a creative destruction. Destruction, but opened the way for stepping over on the crisis situation. Therefore, very important to realize each crisis, even each cruel crisis, like French Revolution, which almost annihilated the majority of French nobility, opened the way for a new world, a new direction of political and social system. Okay, creative destruction that raised the West European economy to the higher growth path by aligning incentive structure more closely with the exploitation of technological potential. Why? Because in the feudal world, it scattered small unit to estate, to, for example, counties. But the conclusion and the experiences of the 14th century crisis opened the way for modernization. Therefore, a 14th century crisis, one of the best examples of creative destruction. For 7 years, died one third of European population, every third person, but opened the way of modernization. What means the modernization? Modernization means, for example, political integration, mean reorganization of market system and unification of measure and way and so, and finally integration, political and cultural integration of Europe. Therefore, if we would like to find the starting point of modern Europe and the global modernization, the starting point was the 14th century crisis. Okay, but I don't want to speak about the geographical discoveries because it's other unit, and in the list of exam question, expected question list, there is no word about the geographical discoveries. Therefore, thanks a lot for your attention.